Welcome to the Storm Watch 9 webcast early on a Wednesday afternoon. I am meteorologist Kevin Skarupa. Winter storm warnings posted for the entire state starting mid to late afternoon and going through most of the day tomorrow. That is our timeline for the snow as it continues to edge in. We've had some light snow showers through the morning, but not much in which has been accumulating. But notice as of the noon hour, back out toward Albany and farther to the west. That is where the accumulating snow continues to slowly make its way in our direction. And for southern areas of the state, an inch or an inch and a half in time for the evening commute. Southern half of the state with the best chance of the most accumulation overnight tonight, where we could see 3 to 6 inches by the time we wake up tomorrow morning, with additional snowfall during the daylight hours tomorrow and lesser amounts farther north. So, area of low pressure spinning back through Iowa, a second area of low pressure will take over to our south, trapping enough cold air in so what you see is rain back to our west. Won't quite make it here, although there could be a light wintry mix in extreme southern areas overnight tonight or closer to the shoreline, which would limit amounts a touch. Here's a look at Futurecast. And again, as we get into the evening commute, we're looking at snowfall anywhere south, essentially, of the White Mountains. Overnight tonight, there is that mix line down near the Mass Pike, a chance that that wanders far enough north that we see a little bit of sleet in extreme southern areas. Otherwise, this is looking like a light to at times moderate snowfall all the way through the daylight hours tomorrow until the system finally pulls away and ends tomorrow evening. Overnight skies will clear and a couple of sunny breaks for us on Friday, only to have another system arrive on Saturday. That one looks warm enough that any kind of a mixture very early Saturday morning would change to rain and wind. So the total accumulation for a good portion of the state looks to be around 6 to 10 inches. The plus here indicates some of the higher elevations that normally get a little bit more than most, like a Jaffrey, an Alexandria, a New London, a Washington, with the better chance of seeing 10 to 12 inches out of this system. And there could be just a little bit less than that right along the border or toward the seacoast with that onshore wind out of this system. Now, you get north of the White Mountains, this one of those general things we tend to see, especially with the low passing to our south, is the White Mountains themselves tend to shadow areas farther north a little bit, limiting amounts a touch, especially in extreme northwestern parts of the state. So a couple of less inches there, but it looks like your main snowfall and most of the accumulation will occur during the daylight hours tomorrow after some light snow tonight. So clouds continue to thicken, some light snow, some flurry activity, up to about an inch, inch and a half in extreme southern areas of the state in time for the evening commute. And then, as I mentioned, by daybreak tomorrow, 3 to 6 inches of snow in southern areas and 1 to 3 inches farther north. We'll continue to see temperatures slowly slip back tomorrow. So we are looking at the snow continuing, light to moderate snowfall before it wraps up during the evening hours. Some sunny breaks for Friday, and then the next system looks like a wintry mix changing to rainfall along with some southerly winds on Saturday.